Today's video is going to be a bit more makery than electronicsy, and it may take me more than one beer to do it. But at the beginning, I'll be drinking Grandpa's Sweater Oatmeal Stout, an old favorite. So as requested in the comments of the mailbag video a couple of months ago when this showed up, I am going to see if I can use this rubber sheet to make a homemade rubber stamp using the laser engraver and a bit of 3D printing. The first thing you want to do anytime you've got a new material for lasering is to run a test grid to find out what the laser does to the material, what your speeds and feeds, your power settings need to be and whatnot. So I shall do that first. And Lightburn has this cool little, what do you call it, test mode. It'll generate a test grid with different power levels and different speeds. So I shall okay that, and we'll frame it and get it set up and run that and just see what it does to this rubber stuff. Oh, there that is, and it came out fairly well, I think. Although the ash or residue or dust or whatever came out kind of white, but that seems to clean off fairly easily with just a bit of water. So that's reasonable. Yeah, I guess that is ash, maybe. So it didn't cut all the way through. We may have to put multiple passes on the outline cutting pass for our rubber stamp when we finally get to making it, or we could just cut it out with a knife like I'm doing here using the engraved line as a score line. I guess that could probably work too. Wow, that stuff is a lot stronger than I expected. That may be good for this project actually. Let me just curve this out and I'll be right back. Taking a closer look at this thing, it looks like the 100% power at 10 millimeters per second went a fair distance in, as did the 80% power, the, what is that, 80% power, 70% power, 60% power. So those seem to do the job for getting down below the surface. So I think I will probably go with, let's go with 80% at 10 millimeters per second for that. And probably have to do two passes at that. How far through did that go? So that outline cut, I'll have to check what the setting was, but that outline cut seems to have gone about a third of the way through, which is probably in this 70 or 80% range. So yeah, I think I'll go with that. So now I just need a logo to use. Unsurprisingly, I'm going to use that one. Although this was just printed in PLA and it came out reasonably readable, but this is the kind of detail that the laser can do with that same logo. So I think I'm going to use that one. And this is just one of those aluminum anodized business cards that I got from AliExpress a whole bunch of time ago. I crazy glued a magnet onto the back of it and just wore that as a badge at a maker fair that I went to earlier in the year. So here we are back in Lightburn. I've got the logo there. That is my black layer, and I've also got this blue layer is a box around it just as a line. So 10 millimeters per second, 70% for the image, which is that part. And the line is 10 millimeters per second at 90% speed, but I'm going to make two passes and see if that will cut it out. So let's send that to the laser and see what happens. it occurred to me partway through cutting that I had to actually flip this around and mirror it, because of course this is going to be a rubber stamp, so we're going to get the mirror image of that. All right, that's all done. And while I was burning it off, let's see now, this was the first one, and it looks like it went fairly deep there, maybe about a quarter of the way in, which is probably fine. And those letters look hopefully raised enough to pick up some ink. But I also decided to do one in the negative direction. They've both got this hole drilled right through the middle of them, and I don't know why. I probably have some little artifact in light burn in my drawing screen there that is on the wrong layer or something. Anyway, whatever. I can live with that, I think. Although it is going to be a visible artifact on that one if I use that one. But, so this one, if I use it as the stamp, it will create white letters with a black border and these figures in black. And this one will create black letters and a black border with these things in white. I'm not sure which one I want to use for that. Let's just clean the ash and dust and whatnot off them. See if that makes any visible difference to them or not. Actually, let's get a stamp pad and just try them without any handle or anything. Just on some paper here. This is likely to get a little bit messy. Hopefully I can manage it not too bad. So there is the first one. Okay. This stamp pad I just grabbed out of the kids' craft drawer. I don't know how inky it is, but we'll see in a minute here. So I think this one is the one that's actually going to show up better for stamping. So I think I will use that one. So while the laser was doing its thing, I went and did some CADing and did some printing and came up with this little block here to mount them on. This block is nothing fancy. It's just two sketches, one rectangular base, one that creates this, and then a third sketch that drills a hole in it. And that hole is for a heat set insert, so I can put a handle on it. Hopefully this works. I don't have a lot of experience with heat set inserts. Oh, it's starting to slowly go in. Cool, cool. All right, I think that's going to work pretty well. Now that is a 1/4-20 insert. And I could use, I suppose, a bolt as a handle, but I have a much better idea. Anybody who's been watching my mailbags for a while may recognize these things. So I think I will use some of those. Those four are the same color. So we'll use those ones. And I think I will use those on a piece of 1/4-20 bolt to make myself a really fancy handle. I don't know. What else am I going to use? A whole bunch of motorcycle pieces that I don't, that go to a motorcycle that I don't actually have. There, I think four of them will make for a nice chunky handle, and they'll even fit into my fingers nicely. Cool. So how long a bolt am I going to need for that? Something like 100 millimeters, give or take. All right, let's see how this goes. That guy in there, stack these units on. And I need to get a nut, and I think I have in here, yes, I do. I have some acorn nuts to be extra fancy. So So that will go down in. Oh, how am I going to tighten that on there? I think I might have to do it this way first. Tighten that on there. Drop this down through the stack. And then spin that onto the bottom. Oh, that's a nice solid thing. Now, yes, my modeling is not great there. But actually, these things are wider than my stamp. And my stamp is scaled so that it fits onto a stamp pad. That was my limiting factor. So now I just have to glue that onto there. And I think the adhesive of choice is going to be JB Quick, which is a 5-minute version of JB Weld. If these will open. That looks like it's fairly well centered on there. Let's put that like that. Put a little bit of clamping pressure on it and take some time to wait for the glue to dry. Okay, I think that epoxy's had time to dry. Let us just give it a shot here. Ink it up really good this time and give it a good solid stamping. I suppose these letters are just a little bit too fine to stand up to the pressure, because I think that's what happened down there. Oh, I chose the wrong one. I was supposed to put this one on. Well, fortunately, I am already in progress of making a second one of these. Since I burned two of these off, I might as well make two. Here is the second one. I've already got the rod cut, and I'm just waiting for this part to print. Which is going to take about an hour or so, so I will spare you that, because you've already seen this whole process already. Hopefully it'll be better with that one. I will, I guess we'll take another break and come back when the print is done. All right, time has passed. Glue has dried. Let's see what happened here. It looks fairly solid on there. Let's just get the stamp pad in and see how it works. That goes that way up. Oh, yeah! I think that came out quite well. Yeah, that is definitely a win. So now I guess I can entertain artistic projects from the family or come up with some other stamps now that I know that this works. Not quite sure what I will put on them artistically yet. Wonder if I can print that out and turn it into a stamp. That might be interesting. So the answer to the question of, can I make a rubber stamp out of, with a 3D print and the laser cutter or laser engraver and things I've got around the house, including way too many of these things, is yes. Yes, I can. And it works quite well. So thanks for watching. I appreciate that as usual. Questions and comments, also, as usual, down below in the comments section. Thanks to whoever the anonymous people were who have been sending these motorcycle parts in. I've got a use out of 8 of them. And that's plenty. I don't need to have a whole bunch more of these. If I need more handles, well, I've still got more. But if I need more handles, I can also 3D print them or lots of other options. But anyway, yeah. Thanks, everybody. I will talk to you later.